Hello, everybody! This is Ultimate Lifeform RB, and welcome to a new episode of Let's Play Pokemon Snap! In our last episode, we explored the volcano and the river, and now we've got a new level for us to explore to start off this episode. However, as we get things going here, you guys probably have noticed that the music is a bit louder and clearer than it normally is. That's because the music is not coming from the actual video here, but from MP3 files. This is because I'm going to try to make this story as short as possible, but as I was recording this footage, for some reason the Hogpog program thought that my mic was activated, so not only did it record the audio from the game, it also recorded my voice, because I do have a tendency to talk to myself when I'm playing a game, and that wasn't what I wanted, since I'm doing post-commentary for this playthrough. So I was kind of worried about what I could do to salvage the video, so I basically decided to mute the video itself and just add in the music tracks through MP3s. You know, I had a little bit of a whoopsie, if you will, but we're not going to let that stop this project or anything, and we're going to move forward as best we can. And speaking of that, we are now in the cave. This is level number 5. And this might be, if not the most difficult in the game, level in the game, maybe second most difficult, because there are a lot of, your photo opportunities here are actually quite limited, and a lot of times, especially at the beginning, you probably saw it with all those Grimer that I tried to bring out, there are some Pokemon that are far away from you that you have to bring closer with either a Pester Ball or with the Pokemon food. And then there's bits like this where you have these Jigglypuff being chased down by Koffing. And you can actually save the Jigglypuff, and you'll want to do that because there's actually a pretty interesting bonus at the end of the level if you save at least one Jigglypuff. And there's going to be a few other little set pieces that we can either trigger or not trigger depending on what you want to do in this level, or depending on your capabilities at this point in the game, because this is definitely not the easiest level, you know? Especially if you're visiting for the first time. But, that's pretty much how this level is. This is definitely another step up in difficulty up from the river. And right here, you can save this Pikachu that's been kidnapped by a Zubat, and you'll get a special Pikachu photo opportunity, which I actually got in my original LP. Unfortunately, in this recording, that did not happen. We also have another mysterious egg. We won't learn the contents of it until much later. And we also have the appearance of Jinx, and she's actually in her original darker skin, not her updated skin. But now we're actually going to get to a very special part at the end of the level involving Jigglypuff, so here it is. That was one part where I did decide to keep the audio up, because I did go silent for that part. Unconsciously, of course, because again, I didn't realize that my voice was being picked up. But yeah, there's that special little bit where you can get a concert from Jigglypuff. If you happen to fall asleep during it, you might want to check a mirror in case Jigglypuff decides to draw on your face like she does in the anime. But in any case, yes, the camera check is back. I know I said in the last episode and in the first episode that I was cutting them out for the sake of speeding up the video. I know, episode 3, and I'm already going back on my word, but this ended up being a short recording, so I decided to just keep these in for the heck of it. Now it's on to Professor Oak's check. How many times have we seen this screen already? Grimer, the sludge Pokemon. You can actually get Grimer to evolve into Muk, but you gotta be kinda quick about it because your opportunities to photograph Grimer are limited. We also have Ditto, the transformation Pokemon. Very useful in Generation 2 for Pokemon breeding. Got Koffing. Not too much to say about him. Weeping Bell. This is also a Pokemon you can make evolve, but didn't do it in this run through. I will do it in the next run through because we are coming back. Make no mistake about it. I talk about the backtracking in this game. There's still plenty of it to do, believe you me. Finally, we have Jigglypuff on stage. Buy your tickets now. Too bad you won't be awake long enough to see the entire show. Yeah, we got the same Pokemon bonus. It would have been larger if we had been able to get all three Jigglypuff, but I'm satisfied with the picture I've already got. And that ups us to 42 kinds of Pokemon. We are 21 Pokemon away from a full report. And Professor Oak simply compliments us on our progress and tells us to go back to the course select because now we have another level unlocked. It is level number 5, or rather number 6, the Valley. This is another difficult level, definitely a step up from the previous ones, probably about on par with the Cave, but for some different reasons. The Valley is a level where you really have to pay attention to what you're doing, and you really have to have some good reaction times, because there are a lot of Pokemon, like in the river, that pop out of the water here, and you have to have a very quick trigger finger to get a decent picture. Right away, we've got Squirtle, the third Kanto starter, and the water type Kanto starter. And yes, that is a mountain of Dugtrio in the background, and yes, that will actually be important to remember at some point in the game. Now watch this Magikarp here. Look at that. Mankey just hit a home run. And then some. Got a Geodude, a Sandshrew. Got a lot of ground and rock types for this level, as well as all the Pokemon that pop out of the water. So a pretty good variety of Pokemon here, actually. Well, within the two types, water and ground. Up here we got a Graveler. The only way to bring him down off the side of the mountain is to knock off these Geodude. And you'll also bring out a Sandslash. So yes, this is another level where you gotta do some special stuff in order to make Pokemon appear. They really sort of hammer that home in the later stages where you gotta do such and such thing to make a particular Pokemon show up. This level probably is the worst about it. Now remember that Magikarp from earlier? There he is. Hit him with a Pester Ball. He will skip across the water diagonally, or laterally, I should say, and boom! There's Gyarados. One of the coolest looking Pokemon ever, even to this day. I love Gyarados. Heck, my final team in Pokemon Yellow, when I did a Let's Play of that game, that featured a Gyarados. My second favorite water type. There's Staryu. Staryu in this stage is very difficult to get a picture of. You have maybe a split second to try and get a good picture before he disappears. However, if you get a picture of him, he will follow you into this whirlpool and turn into Starmie, who is probably even harder to take a picture of. I mean, did you see that? I had no time at all to even attempt to get a picture of him. And at this point, I'm just spamming the Pester Balls because I'm trying to get certain Pokemon to come out of the river, namely Goldeen and Dratini, so I can get pictures of them. Now, to my left, there is a mountain with a special event trigger that I'm totally ignoring right now. But it's actually because I don't want to trigger that event immediately. I will trigger it on the return visit to this stage. And it's going to involve that red switch to the right here, as well as that gate. So there is an alternate exit to this stage, but we're not going to see what it is until later. Not even in this episode, because this is a short episode. I didn't really feel like recording all that much for this one, and I'm just spamming Pester Balls out of frustration because I actually thought that I didn't get a good picture of that last Dratini, but in the camera check, I do actually get a pretty decent one. So there we go, back to the camera check, and let's get some pictures, ladies and gentlemen. Let's get Squirtle. I like this picture here. It looks like the one Squirtle is actually about to jump on the back of the other one. Like, he's so happy for food that he's gonna jump on his buddy to grab it. That's what it looks like from that perspective, anyway. Sandslash. Gyarados. Get some Gravela. Didn't really feel like I got that good of a picture of Gyarados in any of those shots, but I had to pick one to go with it. Got Staryu, and the Starmie pictures were just awful, especially that first one where he's barely in the frame. I can't believe the game actually counted it as actually taking a picture of him. So yes, some Pokemon late in the game are really irritating to get pictures of, I'm gonna be honest. Some of these Pokemon will make you tear your hair out, especially if you make it your mission to get that specific Pokemon. You'll go nuts with some of these things. Geodude gets a decent score. Sandshrew. After I bopped him on the head with Pokemon food. We got Sandslash. Good score on that one. Graveler, there's another segment with Graveler that you can get a really special picture, but it requires an item upgrade that we do not possess right now. There's Gyarados. You will always be an awesome Pokemon. I don't care what anybody else says. You will always be awesome. Just stay away from electric types. Am I right, ladies and gentlemen? Stay away from electric types. Water flying, lethal combination to deal with. Or to take an electric attack from. But anyway, there's Goldeen. And Dratini. Dragon type. His evolutionary line was the only dragon type in Generation 1. That gets us 51 kinds. That's what, 12 Pokemon away from full completion? And Professor Oak mentions a suspicious switch. That was the switch that we saw at the end of Valley. However, if you want to see what that switch does and what it leads to, you're going to have to wait until the next episode to see that, because we are stopping here. We're going to save our progress, and we're going to call it a day here. So that is a wrap on this episode of Let's Play Pokemon Snap. If you folks liked what you saw in this video, please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. I would greatly appreciate it, as always. Hopefully I won't have any audio mess-ups in subsequent recordings, and things will be back to normal somewhat. But this is Ultimate Lifeform RB signing out for now. I'll see you folks in the next episode! Thank you.